Hey everybody, as the card says, St. Patrick's Day is coming up. Hence the green cabinets. So this week and next week, I'm gonna do a couple of Irish favorites. We're gonna start off with Irish cream. It's good stuff. It is essentially cream with Irish whiskey, coffee, and cocoa or chocolate. So I was looking through a bunch of recipes and what I found was a lot of sugar. And I thought, well, what's all the sugar from? Well, all the sugar is from the bitter components that are going into the Irish cream. The first one being the chocolate. Regular cocoa powder is very, very bitter. So how did they get around that in these recipes? Up the sugar. If you like that, that's fine, but I'm trying to cut back on my sugar because I'm trying to cut back on my waist. Still a little bit too big for me. So by using regular cocoa powder, of course, very bitter, you have to up the sugar. The other thing I saw in the recipes was the use of chocolate syrup. Well, what is chocolate syrup? Chocolate syrup is regular cocoa powder with a simple syrup. Well, a simple syrup is sugar and water. Well, if we switch to Dutch processed cocoa, we can get rid of the water, the extra water, we can get rid of the extra sugar, and we cut the bitterness in the cocoa powder. The second source of bitterness is the coffee. Most recipes, I've seen four different sources of coffee in the recipe research that I did. One, regular coffee. Some people like that bitterness, but not in this drink. Two, espresso, which ups the bitterness ante quite a bit. Three, instant coffee. Again, I think that's even more bitter than regular coffee. And of course, four, the ultimate in bitterness, instant espresso. Now, mind you, all of these have their culinary uses, but we want to cut back on that bitterness so we can cut down on the sugar. So, well, one of the things I've done is I've made cold brew coffee. Cold brew coffee, because it is, oh, by the way, the link's up here, because it is brewed using cold water, it takes time. It cuts the bitterness because it's not extracting the bitterness from the coffee bean. Cold brew coffee, very simple. 8 ounces of water to 2 ounces of coarse ground coffee beans. Mix it together, give it a stir, throw it in the refrigerator overnight, you've got cold brew coffee. So let's start mixing this up. We'll talk about mixing to start off with. This can be done in a blender, and if you're going to do it in a blender, I would start putting the stuff in the blender. But I'm not going to use a blender today. I'm going to use an immersion blender. So I am using a blender, but a different type of blender. So I'm going to do it in this container. If you don't have either of those, you can use a whisk, you can use a spoon, either of those will work. They'll take a little more effort, but they will work. So let's talk ingredients. First of all, I am gonna add sugar in it, so I am gonna add sugar to it, but I'm not gonna be overwhelmingly sweet. I don't really care for that in my mixed drinks, so I'm gonna go with one can of sweetened condensed milk. I've seen other recipes that use two of these, plus chocolate syrup. That's a lot of sugar going in. I'm gonna cut it back with just this. So, one can of sweetened condensed milk. And this is the only sugar that I'm gonna be putting in here. This will smooth it out, make it a little silkier. Should make it really good. Let's get that all in there. Shot of my cold brew. Of course, like I said, cold brew is super easy to make. Dutch processed cocoa. Notice how it's a little bit redder than the other stuff? The other stuff is always like this dark brownish gray. And this is kind of red. Using Dutch processed cocoa, you can increase the amount of cocoa you put in there. So if you wanted something more chocolatey, just add about 2 or 3 more tablespoons in. And you've got a very, very nice chocolate Irish cream. Whiskey. Of course, Irish whiskey, you can get anywhere from about $10, $15 bottles all the way up to $70, $80 bottles. I would say go in the $20 to $30 bottle. Now, the other nice thing about this, much like with the Dutch processed cocoa, you can put in as little or as much as you want. It's up to your taste. I'm gonna go with the whole bottle. This is a 75 milliliter bottle. Just dumping right in. Now, the mixing. Again, I'm gonna use my stick blender. If you're gonna use a regular blender, that's fine. Be careful using mechanical means because you could whip air into the cream. We don't want that. Okay, here we go. All mixed up. Beautiful color. Let's talk about storage. I'm gonna be put it in one of these bottles. I got this bottle at my local liquor store. There's a local meadery, yes, Honey Wine, that came in this. That company likes to sell their mead in these bottles with the little resealable top. I like that. I saved the bottle. If you don't have that in your liquor store and you don't want the mead, you can get these bottles, one, online, two, craft stores. Funnel comes in handy. Good, seal it up. This has got to be stored in the refrigerator. The cream is perishable in here. Even with the alcohol and the little added sugar I put in there, this is not gonna land, this will not last at room temperature. So that's going in the refrigerator. Got a little extra, got these jars here. Put a bow on it, it's a nice little gift. So let's talk service. In your coffee would be good, really good. Or how about in our cold brew? A little bit of that in there. make a nice little drink. I also like it just straight on the rocks. So, I'm Chef Terry. I'll be back next week with another Irish recipe. It's a family favorite of my wife's. She's half Irish. Till then, cheers, and I'll see you next week. Oh, one last thing. If you're gonna be drinking this, you're not gonna be using these. Understood? See you next week.